output feedback with integral effect. So you have a system described by this state equation. It is linear, but P is a disturbance which is assumed to be constant. So it can be, for instance, a problem of the modelization of the system, such as the slope of the terrain, or the weight of people, or the wind, or any constant perturbation. We propose the controller which is given here, and I will explain this now, with an integral effect. So let me explain this. The system is described by a state equation of the form x dot equal ax plus bu. It is linear, and there is a constant perturbation, p, and I don't know it. Y equal to cx, so this is my system. X is not available, only is available u and the output y. So y is here. So for the control, what we do usually, we perform an observer for this system, and since p is not known, I will do a classical observer assuming that p is equal to zero. So if I do this, the observer will have the form x hat dot equal a x hat plus bu, so it corresponds to a simulation. P is not known, so I cannot use it, and minus L, the Rheinberger controller or gain, and here is the difference between the predicted output, so C x hat minus y, here the measured output, and the output of this will be x hat. So the input of this system is y and also u. Okay, from this I will have an approximation of x hat. Now I will also use a controller. So the controller we use usually as a form, it is a proportional control, u equal, and I will have minus k integral z, so I will see just now what is z, minus k x hat. So it is what I take for u. So we can see that this controller has as input x hat. But another input is also z, which comes from an integrator. So I put the integrator here. And I will see why it is interesting to have an integrator. So what I will integrate is the error between the quantity I want, so it is a set point, w. So I will have plus minus, so w is here, this is error, and the minus comes from another quantity, which is some desired output, so I will call it YC. We'll see now that YC is a part of the output. So for instance, it will be here, I will put E, some kind of gain, which will select the output I am interested to control via W. So what I want is that YC is equal to W. And this is connected to y, like this. So here I have y, and u is here. So I can understand that the controller corresponds to this. So the controller is this, and we have an integral effect here. This is the controller, and we can see that the input of this controller are y, w the set point, and the output of the controller is u. So why it is interesting to have an integrator? Because the whole system, given here, it is a closed loop system, has for input w and for output y. I will compute the gain L here, ki, k here, these gains, I will compute them so that the whole system is stable. As a consequence, if w is considered as constant, for instance w bar, all y will also converge to something y bar, and also x will converge to x bar, and since if I am able to stabilize the system, all quantities will converge to some specific value that are constant. As a consequence, x dot will converge to zero, x hat dot will also converge to zero. Okay, but what is interesting is that z here will converge to some specific value, z bar. But since it's the derivative of z, since it converges to something constant, will be e, and e will necessarily converge to zero because e corresponds to z dot, and all derivatives will converge to zero. So only due to the fact that I have an integrator here, I am sure that if I stabilize the system, the error will be zero. It means that this quantity will be equal to that quantity. So the error will be zero. Another thing is that y has a dimension which can be, for instance, what I measure. I have three sensors. Here I will have three sensors. W corresponds to will have the same dimension as u, and maybe, for instance, two. So I have two inputs in my system. And here I will have two. The dimension of w is two. As a consequence, the dimension of e is also equal to two. The dimension of yc is two. And I can understand that e is a matrix which will select the output I want to control, because this one is of dimension three. So it is the role of e. It tells me to which output I will affect my set points. So the first question of my problem is to give the state equation of the closed loop system in a matrix form. To find the state equation of my closed loop system, the closed loop system is this one, I will have to find the state first, and then to express the derivative of the state with respect to the state itself and also to the input. So the input is w. The state will correspond to the state of my system, so I will have x first. I will have also the state of my observer, so it is x hat. And I will also the integrator, and what is memorized in the integrator is z. So to have the state equation, I should express the derivative of this one, these quantities, with respect to the state, so x, x hat, and z, and also to the input w. So this is what I will do. X hat is given here, is equal to a x plus b u. So u, I will write it here, because u is not allowed. It's not here. Plus p. So p is a perturbation. It is not known, but I put it here. It is a perturbation. So here I can accept to put p. And u here corresponds to minus minus ki for the integrator z. Z is allowed minus k x hat. X hat is allowed also. Now I will have x hat. X hat corresponds. So it's this. It is a x plus x hat plus b u. So minus k I z minus k x hat minus L minus L multiply by C x hat, so x hat is allowed, minus y, but y correspond to C x. And z hat corresponds to, so e is not allowed, z hat is here, and it corresponds to w minus yc. Yc is not allowed, so I will have w minus yc, and yc corresponds to e, e times y, y is not allowed, and y is equal to cx. So these are the state equation of my system. So as a consequence, I can write in the matrix form. So I will like this, x, z, okay, x hat, okay, I have permuted, here I will have a big matrix, the derivative here, here I will have x, z, and x hat, plus plus something. Okay, so here I can see that I will have the a here due to this minus b k I due to this minus b k due to this, and here I will have plus p. So for the second one, z, okay, so it is the third one here, I will have minus ec due to this, 0, 0, and here w due to this. And for the last equation, I will have here LC, LC, this, after minus BKI, and this, and after A minus BK minus LC, 0. And for the output, I will have to write y equal, okay, so it will be for Cx, I will have C 0, 0 times the state Z x hat. So this is the evolution matrix of my whole system. This is can be seen as an entry, so I did not put it in a matrix form, this part. And here it is the observation matrix. So this is the matrix representation of my closed loop system. All the, so if I want to make it stable, I will have to have this matrix that have the eigenvalues that are on the left part of the complex plane. Question number two, we take epsilon equal x hat minus x, and from this I will have to express the state equation but with a new state equal to x, z and epsilon. So I take these two equations, this one and this one, and I will I know that epsilon is equal to x hat minus x. Okay. So I will do this equation minus this equation, and I will make appear here epsilon dot, because x hat dot minus x dot. Then after I will have here equal to a epsilon due to this. Some terms will disappear, such as this one and this one, equal to zero. Here I will have this term will also disappear. Here I will have this term that will correspond to minus L C epsilon, this, and I will have minus P. Okay. So it will simplify this equation. So if I rewrite it, I obtain here x dot z dot epsilon dot equal. So here I will put the matrix, and here I am only allowed to put x, z and epsilon and plus something. Okay. So I will have to rewrite from this. I know that x or x hat will not be anymore a state variable, so I will replace x hat is equal to x plus epsilon. I will have here a minus pk, because indeed now I do not depend on x hat but on epsilon, and I use here this relation. Here it stays the same because z is still a state variable. Here I will minus pk, here minus ec, 0, 0, and for epsilon it's clear, it is 0, 0, so I use this relation, a minus lc. Here p, set point W, and here due to this I will have minus P. Okay, so this matrix is more comfortable because it is block diagonal. I have this block and this block, and since I have to place a pole, it will be easier when it is block diagonal, because I will have to fix the eigenvalues for this one and the eigenvalue for this one. It makes me possible to separate the problem. Question number 3 shows that we can put the pole, place the pole arbitrarily of the closed loop system. So as previously said, the matrix is block diagonal, and moreover I can this matrix here is equal to a 0 minus e c 0 minus b 0, I write like this, multiply by k k i. So if I write like this, this one by A bar, this one is B bar, and this one is K bar, what I want is to fix the characteristic polynomial of this matrix. But this matrix has the form that the polynomial characteristic of this matrix is the determinant of SI, so a big matrix identity, minus A bar plus P K bar. And the unknown is this one. And I want to fix this one to a desired polynomial. So let's say I will call it, polynomial of S with controllability. And I have an algorithm for this. It is a pole placement algorithm, which is called in Python or in MATLAB or and so on. It is a place function. As a consequence, just to have to place the pole here, I will write in Python or MATLAB or whatever, I will ask k bar is equal to place of A bar, I know A bar, B bar, I know B bar, and the polynomial I want for the control. This will give me k bar, so in the same time I will get K, and I will get Ki. For L, it will be similar. I will have to solve the determinant of Si minus the matrix A plus Lc. So the characteristic polynomial will be equal to the polynomial I want for the observation. I will call it like this. So this is easy to fix K, Ki, and L so that the system, the closed loop system, is stable. Question number four. We have to show that for a constant set point W and the disturbance P, which is also constant, then at the steady state, we necessarily have YC equal to W. And it was exactly what I wanted. So for this, I will write that at the equilibrium I will have question number four. At the equilibrium I will have Z dot. So Z dot is equal to minus E C X plus W. So it comes from the equation I have just above. This corresponds to y. This corresponds to yc. This one is equal to zero because at the steady point, all variables have converged to a constant value, so their derivative converge to zero. As a consequence, I get that yc is equal to W. And it was what I said just at the introduction of this exercise. It is the role of the integrator. Here, the role of the integrator. If the system is stable, then Z will converge to a constant value. So its derivative will converge to zero, but its derivative is the error itself, and the error will necessarily be equal to zero, exactly be equal to zero for all possible constant perturbation. And it is the role of the integrator to do this job. Question number five. This is a controller. It is interesting in practice to have the state equation of the controller because I have to build the controller. The system already exists, but I have to build the electronic of the controller or to make the program which implement this controller. And for this, it is necessary to have the state equation. The state variables of the controller are Z and X hat, not X of course. So I will have to write the derivative of z, the derivative of x hat, the derivative, and also the output u equal. And here I am only allowed to put the state variable, so z and x hat, but also the input of the controller, which is w. So the output of the controller is u here, the input of the controller is w here. Okay. So for z, I will have z dot equal e, but e is not allowed, so I will have w minus y is allowed, it is also an input of the controller here, y, so minus ey. Here for the second one, I will copy this, x hat equal a x hat plus b u, but u is not allowed, so I have to replace u by minus k I z minus k x hat, so b u minus l, so here I will have c x hat is allowed, minus y. Okay. And u is equal to, as said previously, written here, minus k I z minus k x hat. Again, I can put this in a matrix form. I will have c dot x hat dot equal, so here I will have 0 0 minus b k I a minus b k minus l c z x hat plus identity minus e 0 l w and y, and for u I will have u equal I will have minus k I minus k multiplied by the state z x hat. So this is the state equation of the controller. The output is u, and the input is the set point w, but also the output of the system y.